Hi, my name is Mae Bolburn, and I'm a Board Certified Behavior Analyst with DiNovi and Associates. In this video, I'll be talking about behavior analysis in hospitals. Applied behavior analysis can be used in conjunction with other medical treatments to improve the quality of care of patients. It can also be utilized to treat problem behaviors, especially when they interfere with medical treatment recommendations. Research has shown that ABA has been effective for treating many disorders, including alcoholism, anxiety disorders, depression, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, obsessive compulsive disorder, and to manage fears. I'd like to highlight a few specific interventions and a brief overview of some behavior analytic treatments in hospitals and other settings. In the Cataldo et al. Article, they address how children in intensive care units may be isolated from caregivers and other children, be exposed to a number of children with life-threatening illnesses or injuries, witness critical medical interventions, and undergo painful medical procedures. This may result in a decrease of age-appropriate responses and increased problem behaviors, which makes appropriate medical treatments more difficult to provide and the transition to the home environment more challenging. Two different studies were completed. The researchers demonstrated that behavioral assessment procedures can provide an empirical basis for designing pediatric intensive care unit routines affecting children's psychosocial status and therefore improve current procedural designs to provide quality medical care. In the Derrickson et al. Article, a signaling procedure was used to increase positive behaviors such as smiling and eye contact and decrease negative behaviors such as crying and whining in both non-invasive and invasive caregiver events. A visual and auditory signal was turned on by medical staff prior to an invasive medical procedure and turned off immediately after the procedure. As a result, positive behaviors were observed more and negative behaviors were observed less during non-invasive and invasive procedures when the signaling device was present. In the Matthews et al. Article, the participants were young children whose eye lenses were surgically removed. The children would benefit from the use of contact lenses for their severe nearsightedness. A shaping procedure was used to teach the children how to wear contact lenses. Infection increased noncompliance, but within the hospital setting, the shaping procedure was successful for almost all the participants. In the SLIFER et al. Article, the researchers examined the implementation of operant conditioning procedure to reduce the movement of young children to allow neuroimaging to occur without sedation. In the Stick and MILAN article, the study did not occur in a hospital setting, but rather in an independent living facility for elderly residents. In this article, prompting, such as a heart symbol to indicate low cholesterol and calorie-modified food and other visual cues, feedback in the form of a graph of healthy food choices made in the dining area and social reinforcement from the maitre d' and hostess were used to increase the number of healthy food choices. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel and disseminate the science. Share this video. Bye. Bye.